Mr. Gregg, 2 minutes.
Thank you. We were talking about job opportunities, and Rupert was. I want to share with you, as I've traveled around the state, these opportunities that I've talked about in advanced manufacturing, agriculture, logistics, energy, and life sciences. They are so interwoven. When I travel the state of Indiana, and if I'm going up to Muncie, or if I'm going up to Anderson, or going up north to the region, and I see the wind turbines, this fascinates me. I just don't see the opportunity to create alternative energy. I see the opportunity to grow our economy. I ask myself why those wind turbines, over 85% of them, are made overseas. I ask myself why that aluminum blade comes shipped here rather than being made at Alcoa in Boonville or Lafayette. That pole that holds it up, in my vernacular, it ain't no Georgia pine. And I wonder why it's not made out of steel made in Indiana, and why the hub isn't cast at a foundry in LaPorte, and why the wire didn't come from the old Essex plant in Fort Wayne. We can do that when we work together and don't get distracted on issues that divide us. We make rail in this state at Fort Wayne. We make the rail cars in Muncie, Indiana. We make those ginormous diesel engines in Columbus and soon to be in Seymour. But yet we've got no rail policy. As governor, I'll bring us together. I've done this as Speaker of the House, and I'll bring us together in a bipartisan fashion. I'm proud of my record as Speaker in having brought both sides together. I'm the only candidate that has experience in doing that. I've balanced our budget, I've improved funding for education, and I've cut Hoosiers' taxes, and I've always done so in a bipartisan way. We in Indiana need to stay away from divisive issues. We can't even agree on class basketball and time zones. So let's leave these other issues alone, okay?
Mr. Bonham, a minute.